gamers of the internet, we're back with Phoenix Wright.
Ace Attorney, I've noticed something about SLP, Ben. Notice that we've not downed once.
No, we haven't.
Which is kind of funny,
but
because the sips can be quite full on, but we've not downed. And that's, I feel like that's a thing that maybe we should take into consideration here. Because it can't, even no matter how bad it gets with the sips, we've not downed yet. And downs can be real fucking kickers sometimes. So we can count our lucky stars. That's someone. Sorry, the name star got deleted from my vocabulary as soon as we met the cough up queen.
Yeah. But you know what's funnier? It's like, I was going to say, even though we haven't downed, I've actually felt very drunk playing this game quite a bit sometimes.
Yeah. Sips, man.
Yeah,
they pile on.
They do pile on. They come on quick.
Glad they're not mixing with downs because we're fantastic at mystery games.
Yeah.
Clearly. Let's talk to Edgeworth.
Alright.
How's it going, mate? How's the trauma? No more nightmares, I hope. You're doing better, pal.
So the body was found in your car?
Go ahead, say it right. You think I did it, don't you?
After what happened last time, no.
It is your car, and it does make you a suspect, but it's definitely not you.
Yeah.
I went through all that trouble to help me last year, no less.
Last year?
Last year.
Oh, wait, so when the 2 months elapsed, also New Year's happened?
Oh, fuck. February, yeah. Yeah, because it happened in December, remember?
Yeah.
Merry Christmas.
Yeah. No, we don't think you did it. I mean, it was my sister who stabbed him.
Sorry, it was definitely my sister. Oh, shit.
Wait, no. She didn't do that, I mean.
Whose side are you on, you dense motherfucker?
Oh.
Wait. So you're the chief prosecutor's little sister, then?
Yes, sir. Emma Skye. It's nice to meet you again.
Now, that didn't sound forced at all. No, sir.
Ah, now I remember. You've really grown. I'll admit, it was a surprise to me too. To think that my own car would become the scene of a murder. More surprising still, I'm being forced to prove my superior's guilt. Oh, fuck! Oh, shit!
Ion, are we up against Edgeworth? Oh, no.
Memory's broken.
No.
The truth goes unspoken. I've even forgotten my name.
Shit.
The only thing I know for real, there will be blood.
Oh, God.
Once a rival, always a rival.
Oh, damn.
When the call comes, people are going to answer it.
Yeah. I can understand. Wait, what did you say?
No, the first line, though.
Yeah.
Lena Skye is the chief prosecutor, the top prosecutor in the district. She can't prosecute herself, so I'll be the prosecutor at her trial tomorrow.
Shit.
Fuck.
You, Mr. Edgeworth?
It's just a job, Mr. Wright.
Nothing personal, kid.
No!
To be honest, it's a bit of a miracle I'm still here at all.
What do you mean?
Rumors. You've heard the rumors about me, haven't you?
Miles Edgeworth. Oh, no. It's hard to remember a time when there weren't rumors about this guy.
Back when he was being scummy.
Yeah. Forging evidence, arranging false testimonies, legal searches, you name
it. Von Karma's puppet.
Yeah.
God, that guy just ruined everything with a single gunshot, didn't he?
Yeah. Everyone. Every single person.
Yeah, thanks to you, my innocence was established in the trial at the end of the last year. Ripped my boy Anyogi, he got it real bad.
Oh, yeah. You've been forced to play along as a absolute brain-damaged person.
I mean, he's not my boy, to be honest.
Nah.
He did do a bit of a bad thing,
yeah.
But honestly, I do feel pity for him.
Yeah.
However, there are some who say I'm the one responsible for the current incident.
What? That's crazy!
Some people need very little excuse to think ill of others. Oh, damn. Edgeworth versus Twitter already, okay.
Oh.
It's a fact of life. Impossible to stop.
What's Twitter?
Oh, yeah, you're right. Twitter was a thing back in 2001.
Oh, yeah, okay. Fair enough. Yeah, it was.
It's a fact of life. Impossible to stop.
Was it? Or was it 2003?
2001's commentary to social media.
I think that was Facebook 2001, actually.
Oh, I think it was actually... No, it wasn't. No, do you know what? It fucking wasn't 2001. No,
MySpace.
That's...
MySpace.
MSN.
MSN and MySpace.
MSN, my... Yeah, damn, yeah. Those talk text groups. Yeah, Twitter wasn't the thing back then. No, I'm stupid.
No.
I may be stupid. Some of them even go so far as to present me with toys like this. They think it's funny.
Why? What what is the K for?
K for cool,
toys,
crusty,
bronze shield.
Because you're washed up.
Toys, that bronze shield, there's got to be a story behind that one.
Yeah, what the hell is that, yeah, actually?
We'll do some searching after.
We've got to examine his office, absolutely. Chief Prosecutor Sky, yes, we first worked together on a case 2 years ago. It was my first big case.
That's right. I remember. 2 years ago, I wasn't even a lawyer yet.
Since then, I always thought that she was looking out for me.
Hmm.
It appears I was mistaken.
Mistaken? Why? I mean, I know she's not the warmest person, but I'm sure she felt some responsibility for you.
Then, why? Why did she stab someone in the trunk of my car?
Oh,
Edgeworth thinks that she did it.
Oh, shit.
Not only that, she stabbed him with my knife.
Oh, he had a knife?
You had a knife. And
he had a knife?
Open up tin cans, right?
Yeah.
Is Edgeworth a fan of Knifey Spoonie?
What? Mr. Edgeworth, your knife was the murder weapon?
Of course, it's the same color as his suit.
Yeah.
Everything must be a weird red shade of pink.
Yeah.
To be specific, it was the knife I keep in the toolbox in the trunk of my car.
How'd you keep a knife in a toolbox in the trunk of your car?
Knives are important, man.
Mm.
You know, you want to cut out someone's kidney before it explodes because they've been holding their piss for too long. Knife comes in clutch.
Jesus.
Someone's threatening you to be an arsehole on your bar, bring out the knife.
Oh.
Don't thank the people, thank the knife. Thank the UK. You're welcome, world.
Knives.
The murder weapon. Eugene Edgeworth's toolbox. Traces of victim's blood. No prints.
Edgeworth.
What?
Are you sure you didn't do it?
Straight
after
up.
Everything
did you do this one, though?
Okay, just checking. Just let the mate up, but are you sure?
I know all the evidence pointing to you in Chapter 4 wasn't you, but this is a vague piece of evidence. Does that mean it was you?
Yeah.
Just like some reverse psychology work on us.
He's joking.
Oh my god, Phoenix. You were actually joking. I can't even tell with him anymore.
Can't he take a joke? You have a strange sense of humor, Mr. Wright.
Yeah, that was uncalled for.
Wow.
Arsehole.
That was deep.
Let's have a look.
We'll present before we move on.
Oh, okay. Usually you examine before you start presenting.
Oh, okay. Yeah, okay. We can examine.
Whatever. Just in case something happens in between something. You never know with this game.
True.
What is that?
Wow. This jacket is even lacier than his usual one. This must be his lucky trial jacket.
Yeah, Drift wears a lot of lace, huh?
Yeah. Lucky jacket, right? I've never seen him wear it.
Methinks the defense attorney protests too much there, Phoenix.
Yeah. I'm sure there's a story behind why it's in a frame. Maybe I'll be naughty and take a picture.
Oh, shit.
She's getting way too excited about this. She's fangirling all over.
Oh, she's going to get them clicks.
Yeah.
Mr. Edgeworth has such a comfy sofa. Sofas like this make me
want to curl up and take a nap.
I bet he pours over his case files here until the wee hours of the morning. Then he takes off his jacket, rolls up his sleeves.
Whoa.
No. Whatever. Let's see where this goes.
And goes to sleep, using his arms as a pillow.
See, I knew it'd be wholesome at the end.
I don't believe it. She's actually daydreaming about Edgeworth working.
She's an Uber fangirl.
Yeah. I bet in the morning he has so... She probably has fan.
Oh my god. She honestly, yeah, fan writer energy right here.
I bet in the morning he has sofa hair and little creases in his cheeks from The Sims.
Oh man, if she sees anything... If she sees any energy with Phoenix and Edgeworth, they're done for. Notepad is going out straight away.
Oh, absolutely.
If she notices something.
Yeah.
Mind you, she's kind of a dumbass, so I think they're safe.
I feel like she might notice something. Who knows?
And she's a bit of a dumbass, though.
He's so cool.
In the common sense kind of way.
Yeah. What was that? I can't remember. There's like a voice clip that goes, "He's so cool," but I don't remember where it's from.
In what?
No, it's just like an advert.
An advert?
I think Reggie said it or something.
Who?
Reggie Fils-Aimé said it, or I can't remember.
What, from Nintendo? Yeah. Is he an American president?
I don't know if it was him, but it's from Nintendo. It's something from Nintendo.
So cool.
I don't remember what, but it was meme for a little while.
First, of course, is
Edgeworth,
who will be played by Chris Pratt. He's so cool.
Okay. Oh, no, are you sure it wasn't My Body Is Ready? That's completely different.
My Body's Ready is a different one. Sofa Hair is cool. Okay, come on.
Thanks for stopping by. I have to go back to my copy of Phoenix Wright Ace Attorney on my Nintendo 3DS.
Nah. Hey, a chessboard! I'm not too up on my chest, but it looks like blue's in a bit of a tight spot.
Yeah, cause fog blue.
Yeah.
Edgeworth probably like fantasizes it, like compares to a quorum. Take this, Mr. Wright. Objection this. Now for the crowning altered evidence.
Yeah. The red knights have surrounded the blue pawn. Huh? Those horses are mounted knights. Their swords have really sharp edges. Check out that poor pawn.
But they're worth a lot
his
as well.
Yeah,
well, actually he is. That's great. And now I hit you with my trump card. The autopsy report in updated form.
No.
Boom.
The dance comes out.
Yeah.
Oh, God.
This is Edgeworth dances to himself in his own office.
Oh, I can bet he did Edgeworth dance in his own office.
That's great.
Kind of spiky. Kind of remind me of you. Mr. Edgeworth must be an avid chess player. What's wrong, Mr. Wright? And she's surrounding the pawn with spiky hair. Nah, it's nothing. Damn it.
I want a Phoenix Wright chess set now.
Probably is wrong. My. What an amazing bouquet. Just right for Mr. Edgeworth. No kidding. Hey, there's a card on it. Back from the dead. Wendy?
What?
Wendy? I've heard that name somewhere before.
Oh, Wendy Oldberg?
Oh, Wendy!
Yeah.
Yeah!
Oldberg. The woman that single-handedly murdered my throat.
Oh my god, and beside it, a giant steel samurai. Oh my god.
They called me the cough-up king back in chapter 3 thanks to that old bag.
Oh, wow. Wow, I want one. Huh? There's something written on the bottom of his foot? Between a rock and a hard place.
Wendy. That's cute. She gifted her edgy wedgie.
Aw. Wendy, is she Mr. Edgeworth's fiance? Aww.
I feel like Edgeworth's not going to say no to free steel samurai merch. Yeah, there she be. The woman of our dreams.
I don't think so. Whoa! What a view. It must be nice to have an office on the 12th floor. I guess you would feel important. Incidentally, were you to jump out of this window,
Jesus,
the time until impact with the ground would be...
Bit of a random morbid thought there.
Just write it down. So if there was a bomb in this building,
how much blood would spread out of the corpse when they hit on the time of impact, I must know.
Got it! Approximately 3.226.
Dark.
That's handy to know.
That's some big fall damage.
Yes.
Afternoon tea.
Oh, cute. What a pretty tea set.
Bring out the scones.
I got more for the instant tea bags.
My man.
Amazing. The drawer below is filled with packets of tea leaves.
Oh, I'm definitely more of a coffee lover.
No.
I'm more about that bean soup.
I like lattes and mochas in my coffee. I don't go too deep in the coffee field.
I'm definitely a mocha guy. I like me chocolate, yeah, hot chocolate and all that. Mocha is always the most expensive thing on the menu, though, according to like all the other sets.
Yeah, latte's good, though, as well.
Latte's all right.
I like latte. Latte's more creamy.
A bit creamy for one taste, but it is nice, yeah.
Especially when you add, when you add
espresso, I had to inject straight into my veins when I wake up at 5 o'clock in the morning for my lifeguard shifts, because it's necessary. Trust me.
They're all sorted by places of origin and flavor.
Comments, prefer tea or coffee?
Ooh, that's a... Because I've got some good teas at home now.
Let's sort of a debate once and for all.
There are some nice teas out there. We pick up all these random teas sometimes. Right at the moment, I've got shortbread tea I'm really into at the moment.
A bit fancy. Sounds
it's
nice,
like,
though.
It's shortbread.
Mm-hmm.
The biscuit.
Yeah.
It's like drinking that, but in tea form.
Oh, good. Okay.
Pretty nice.
You drink the biscuit.
Sort of. It's like basically drinking biscuit, but it's nice.
Oh man, I have I have Lotus biscuits in my crepes sometimes.
Those are nice.
That shit's nice. Not gonna lie. Absolute diabetes, but it's nice.
Yeah, you're good.
More calories, the tastier, right?
Can't go wrong with a bit of Biscoff. Look at this royal blend. What an exquisitely splendid concoction. There's such a thing as taking a hobby too far.
Yeah, thanks, Phoenix. Ladder.
Whoa! These are all case files. They're stacked up to the ceiling. There's even a ladder.
Odd. I thought Edgeworth wasn't good with height.
Oh!
Oh, he's a man after your heart, Edgeworth.
Just like me, for real, for real.
He must have someone get them for him. Ah!
Oh, of course.
Get up on the ladder.
Work for that shiny penny.
Yeah. Why did I just picture the dead Gumshoe? Because he's dead and deceased. I've got it.
No. I feel like it would be a much bigger chalk on if it was Gumshoe.
Yeah. He must study these case reports so closely. He's so cool. That's going to drive me mad. I need to find that voice line.
What is this line that you're talking about?
It's definitely from a Nintendo Direct or something, and someone said it.
He's so cool.
I'm going to have to dig into this myself, because now you're bugging me with it a little bit.
It was definitely from a Nintendo Direct. Okay. It might have been an Indie World, actually.
It's so cool.
You wouldn't say that if you saw him sweating bullets up on the ladder. Oh. Is that it? I think that's...
Or at the actual desk. Yeah.
A word desk. It's quite tidy, as one expects. What a nice desk. Easy to use and easy on the eyes.
Just like Edgeworth himself.
It's polished so well. I can see my own reflection.
Just like Edgeworth himself.
Oh my god. Gumshoe cleans it. Strange. Why don't you finish your Gumshoe?
Your Gumshoe's his pack mule.
Well, I'll take that. Name plaque as a souvenir. I don't think that's called stealing.
Edgeworth, please don't pay. Please pay your detective and please pay your slaves.
Pay your slaves, yeah. I think that's it. Oh, and the cave statue. I've been wondering, what the heck is this? It has a big K on it.
Prosecutors.
What was that?
It's the King of Prosecutors trophy.
Oh, they broke it.
Oh shit.
That's it. KKK? Oh.
Ben! Stop, you muppet.
Oh, well, shit.
I saw that. I'm like, Ben's not gonna. You fucking did, you twat.
King of prosecutors?
I swear to God. It's a great honor. They send their shield to the best prosecutor each year. I hate you so much sometimes. What? So?
I should have used the...
Just stop.
Yeah. So that K... That's... K stands for King.
Yeah, you got a problem with that? And design the thing.
King of Prosecutors. Kind of like Employee of the Month, only better.
It's a bit pompous for an Employee of the Month. It's a freaking trophy with a big fat K on it.
Oh, wait, there's more to it. So that's the King of Prosecutors shield, huh? Well done, Edgeworth. You must be proud to be the King of Prosecutors. Why do I feel like Phoenix is mocking him? Here?
Because he knows that Edgeworth's embarrassed by it. So he's going for the throat.
Yeah.
As I would also do, to be honest.
Congratulations, King! of prosecutors.
King! Congratulations, King!
King of prosecutors!
You're a king, you dropped this! Please stop saying that.
That still doesn't explain one thing. Why is the tip of this shield broken off? Alright.
Maybe he thought there was chocolate inside, like the attorney badge.
I say we examine these things.
Show it off to him, yeah. Oh, it's 3D! Everything is 3D now! It's so weird! Alright, yeah, we're going to use the Saul Goodman mechanic. Let's have a look.
Right, nothing
here. Oh, I just called it that when I said I wasn't. Fuck, I think it's too late for us.
It's got a fist.
What's at the bottom of it? That's the top.
Oh, no, sorry. Oh, yeah, it's something at the bottom. Hey, check it out. There's a metal plate here. It looks like the name of all the previous recipients are engraved on it.
Does it get passed along or something?
Wow, one guy's listed a bunch of
times. I bet it's Karma. Yeah. Oh, God, that name. That fucking name. Jesus.
Oh, yeah.
No, thank you. Cuba Dark Souls music. Remember I see that damn name.
I guess he must be a foreigner? Yeah, that's probably it.
Yeah, that's a German name, isn't it?
Well, whatever. He's from here. Must have been an amazing prosecutor.
He's from
Rushmany. Oh, no, you would not. I'd like to meet this Mr. Von Karma sometime.
No,
I think
you don't.
He's dead.
Yeah, okay, let's go meet him. Oh, yeah, graveyard. Yeah. This wasn't what I had in mind.
Yeah.
Say hi to Von Karma, Emma.
When she says it, his name does have a kind of ring to it.
Also, I realised that his name is a massively obscure pun, but it's a pun name.
Is it?
It is, yeah.
Von
Manfred von Karma. Take out the R's and replace them with L's. Manfleden. Von Karma.
Man fled from
Karma.
Karma.
Because he got away with it for 15 years.
Oh my god. What? That's a genius pun.
Until he did a really stupid thing and got involved with the Yanni Yogi revenge scheme. Because his pride was like, I gotta get the sun though.
Oh my god, that's such a good pun.
Yeah. There you go.
Okay, what else we got?
The knife.
Blood on it.
We're experts at looking at knives. Let's have a look see here.
This is a good knife. It's good. It's a good shanking knife, I think.
Yeah, it's pretty pointy, you know.
Pretty pointy.
We're going pretty deep. Do a bit of damage.
It's not serrated, though, just to let you know. It doesn't look serrated.
Oh, yeah, you can't go in and out and in and out. Yeah, no. It's just one shank and that's it. Simple but effective.
Yeah. This must be the victim's blood, right? Either that or Edgeworth cut himself peeling an apple. Which
with
honestly.
Just use an actual peeler then.
What's Edgeworth doing with a knife like this anyway? Hey, maybe he spends his weekends roughing it in the wild.
What?
Edgeworth in the wild? I think my fruit peeling through is more likely.
Edgeworth just doing like Resident Evil 4-esque knife fights with the rest of the prosecutors. Just imagine Von Karma in like an army suit training like Edgeworth up with a knife fighter.
Oh my god. Oh, that's funny. Are you kidding? I always pictured him as an outdoorsman. Now that's a scary thought.
Edgeworth on the range.
Anything else on this side? It's just blood. Yeah, it's blood. I guess we present evidence.
Yeah, the show and the shit. Oh man, he's gonna be a lot longer now that we actually have to look and examine the evidence as well.
So basically, this says you were the best of the best last year, huh?
Except for which grin elsewhere, right? What's a day of work to receive that travesty?
Huh? Why is that?
Had to go to the police department to receive that broken shield.
Police department?
Yes, right next to the police station downtown. You've been there, haven't you?
Where Detective Gumshoe works? Yeah. I was wondering something about your shield. Why is it broken?
What does it matter? I've got more important things to worry about.
Oh, right. He doesn't seem too concerned about his award for better or for worse.
Yesterday was a very busy day for the prosecutor's office.
Maybe we should ask him about more about yesterday? Okay, that's...
I think we've got another dialogue option after doing that, maybe.
Yeah.
It's against my policy to discuss evidence with the defense, even though I just discussed the trophy with you.
Yeah.
Especially you.
He doesn't like you much, does he, Mr. Wright?
Oh, he's just a big Simpson.
Nah, with Edgeworth, it's never personal. It's all about winning tomorrow.
That's true love right there.
Say, Edgeworth, I was wondering about this. Mr. Wright! Huh? What? Are you sure you should be showing that to Mr. Edgeworth? Oh, he'll take it for sure, won't he? I wish I could be on the same side as Mr. Edgeworth.
Honestly, real talk, I feel like in the forensics, in the record room in Chapter 4 when they meet Karma and they get tasered. Probably shouldn't have shown Karma the letter.
No.
The incriminating evidence towards him, maybe he could have saved it. I mean, it worked out in the end, but maybe don't do that so much
tased.
More in the future. Just show the murder suspect the letter that damns him while not in a court. Yeah, that's not the best of ideas, to be honest.
If it wasn't for that, they wouldn't have got the bullet.
That's what I'm saying. It worked out, but it was still kind of a dumb thing to do.
Oh, yeah, definitely.
In practice,
you wouldn't do that.
Yeah. Don't do that.
I've got the smoking gun here that's going to send you down. Really now.
Is that so?
Yeah.
Show the enemy your cards, why don't you?
But then my sister would be found guilty. If this has any deeper, I'm going to start getting depressed.
You wanna buy it? I once dreamed of being a defense attorney a long time ago.
What? You wanted to be a defense attorney, Mr. Edgeworth?
Yeah, my path is laid out clearly before me. I have no time to reflect on what might have been. Aw, shit. Oh. No way back, just through.
The day of the crime. Could you tell me more about yesterday, the day of the murder?
Yesterday was the annual cleaning day at your prosecutor's office.
Cleaning day.
Working with the police department, we saw and follow evidence for solved cases.
You mean basically Gumshoe comes around and does all the work for you?
Maybe. Like 99%.
Yeah, probably.
We call it evidence transferal.
Just Gumshoe holding massive file boxes and walking around. Wiping your hands of old cases. In other words...
Oh, another thing. A ceremony was held at the police department. There's an annual review and awards for outstanding police officers and prosecutors.
Oh. And that's when you got the shield.
Hooray! Hip hip for Edgeworth. I was at the police department yesterday afternoon. I got back here at 5.
Hang on, isn't that the same time as the murder?
I think so. Go have a look quickly. Oh wait, we haven't got a case file, have we? Nope.
No. Oh, how old is she? Oh, 31.
31.
That's very precise. People like myself and Mr. Edgeworth pride ourselves on our precision, Mr. Wright.
No, I place little faith in my memory. The only thing I trust is solid evidence.
Parking ticket.
Ah,
yeah, you got a parking ticket. Oh, you got a parking ticket. A
record of parking in the prosecutor's office lot. Yeah, it's a receipt that you get whenever you pay for parking.
I'm pretty sure she said that the stabbing happened at 5:12.
I can't exactly remember. I vaguely remember her saying that time as well, yeah. This is the parking stuff in the underground lot.
Oh!
Oh, there you go. Pretty close then. Oh shit, that is really close.
That is really freaking close.
Oops.
Yeah. The murder took place around 5:15. So the murder happened right after you got back.
What, Mr. Wright?
What, right?
I'd appreciate it if you direct that suspicious glare elsewhere.
Oh, who's this?
Oh! New guy! New skipper!
Oh my god.
You can voice this guy, he seems like your kind of energy.
Okay. Excuse me, but is Mr. Edgeworth anywhere on the premises?
I'm Edgeworth, what is it?
I'm here, sir, at the request of the chief, sir. I've got your report, sir.
We finally see a cop that isn't Gumshoe.
Wow.
Report? What, did you find new evidence in the case against Chief Prosecutor Skye?
I don't know the way this conversation is going at all. Skye, sir? No, sir!
No name of that kind, sir! Not in this report, sir!
Oh.
That's a goofy design.
That is a very goofy
design. Super cartoony.
Yeah. Oh, I think I just heard Edgeworth's lid blow.
Mr. Edgeworth's lid isn't on very tight, is it?
Made it clear across to the police department, did I not? I need to focus on the trial tomorrow, so don't bring me anything unrelated!
Sir! I'm just following orders, sir! They told me to bring this to you!
The expressions on this man?
No, it's very cartoony.
Heard they're all just like that. These are just for cops.
Yeah.
It's not one character, it's all of them.
Yeah.
All the police look and sound exactly the same.
I wasn't aware of- Oh!
Give me your name!
Yes, sir! Meeks, sir! Officer Meeks!
Meekins?
Is there a pun there? Meekins.
If I hear a first name, maybe. Right. Officer Meekins, take your report and leave. Good luck with that raise next month.
Oh, fuck. Oh. Getting his salary.
You're gonna need it.
But, sir, I didn't know!
He's got a male man from Twilight Princess energy.
Oh, yeah! Oh, I see it! I see that! Yeah, he has got that kind of energy. Oh, poor guy. Looks like he was absent on the day they gave our brain.
That's kind of a raw insult, Phoenix.
Damn. That is tough.
Surrounded by idiots. Right.
Yes, sir! You caught me off guard.
As you can see, I'm busy. You may leave now.
Let's do what he says, Mr. Wright.
The victim was a detective from the same department as the patrolman just now. Go down to the police department. You can ask more there.
Thanks. Seemed to have finally calmed down at least. Oh.
Alright, we better shoot then.
Never mind.
I'm busy preparing for tomorrow. I'm not in the mood for idle banter. Especially not with you.
Never mind. Maybe we can...
Yeah, we gotta go.
...up on the parking stuff.
Miles Edgeworth, 512, 21st of February, prosecutor's office.
This is dated the day of the crime. The murder took place 3 minutes after everyone parked his car. If only he was held up at a couple extra red lights. He wouldn't have been caught up in this whole affair.
Usually it's a bad thing when you get held up by a red light.
Perhaps. Just go to show you. You never know what happens when you run a yellow light. Why do you think he's running a yellow light?
I mean, when it goes yellow, it means you can go as long as it's clear.
I mean, no. You're meant to be ready to go.
No, Ben, you sweet summer child. You'll find out when you have a car one day.
Yeah, I'm sure I will when I'm actually on the road. I mean, I know what you mean, but... Oh, dear.
All the rules that you learn driving school.
They just go breaking away.
Half of them go, to be honest.
Oh, shit. Can we ask her about the parking spot?
Oh, Jesus.
And the... Oh.
Yeah, cough up some dialogue, sweetheart.
Yeah.
Be true to your name.
Take a look at this. You? Yes. You said you wanted some hot tea. Oh, bloody. Is that count as food? Or
that's
drink?
Technically a drink. And the rules state that should be food, so we're good. You can't
eat a
drink.
She's got a nothing hand out for you.
You can't eat a drink. Have some air.
Yeah.
It's cold.
Yeah.
And I'm great at cold stuff.
No, but thanks. She didn't even look at me.
Why do you want her to look at you, Phoenix?
You must have to brew these leaves a long time to get rid of
Forget the
sow, like
Mr. Wright. She ain't worth it.
Pre-infuse the leaves with steam blowing before brewing. I knew it! So that's the secret to that aroma. Exquisite! Anything I'm smelling here, the wasted time.
She's got the April May / Lotta Ha theme as well. AKA Annoying White Woman theme song.
Oh, wow!
Hey, I'm just saying.
Let's come up with What About the Knife?
It's a banger, I won't lie.
That is a good song.
Oh, it is good.
Inspired Toby Fox, isn't it?
No, that was the Turbo Sisters theme. That inspired a Toby Fox song.
Can we, wait, before we, can we slide now? Oh, we can't. We, damn it, we still can't slide. That's a shame. Alright, I guess we're moving on.
Do 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 do.
Oops, I didn't know.
Nothing here.
No.
We need to go to...
Riot's office, and then it's back, isn't it?
I think.
I can present her with stuff.
I think you could talk to her about some stuff. Or maybe not.
I know the defense attorney has a tendency to want to show people things. What is this? A behavioral study of lawyer?
God, Phoenix's office is just so nothing compared to Edgeworth's. The contrast is kind of funny.
Yeah, there's nothing in it. Yeah. There's no, like, semblance of anything for...
I hope it gets more decorated as the games go
that
on.
That would be cool. That would show character growth.
Show over development.
Yeah.
Oh
no, it's that weird freaky thing.
Oh, it's finally happening.
It's that weird freakish...
The chief of police finally got the pitch in and I think it would.
Oh.
It looks so crappy. It looks so bad.
We're finally here. Why would they put the police department so far away from the prosecutor's office? Beats me, they took almost 30 minutes by taxi, and traffic wasn't even that bad.
That is actually quite long, yeah. Half hour journey, damn.
The police department, huh? I've only been to criminal affairs next door. Hold on, what's that?
It's the badger.
My nightmares. Oh my god, my nightmares.
Why is it in a film? What's not really in a... Oh, I thought that was an FMV for some reason.
That is... Yeah, no, that's disturbing.
The one little smudge on its eye on the left is doing wonders for the horror factor.
Yeah.
Absolute wonders.
Disturbing. Why does it unlude like that? What?
It's slow movements and thousand-yard stare.
It's creepy.
I feel like my soul is being violated a little bit.
Oh my god. Oh wait, I know. This is the blue badger. They're trying to make him the police.
I can't
mascot.
Stop looking at it.
It's that one eye.
It's just everything. It's the
is
face.
Is that intentional? Is that actually intentional? It's... That one eye that's like slightly drooping.
Look how shoddily made it is.
Yeah.
Is that a killer in Dead by Daylight by any chance? Because if not, I feel like that's a good pitch for the next killer.
Wow, Mr. Wright, you sure know a lot about the police. Still, he does seem familiar somehow. He's not as good as Astral Chain's mascot.
Oh my god, Lappy, the lapdog. Yeah, that's a big one. There's a waifu inside Lappy.
Yeah, exactly. 10 times better than him. Forget the blue badger. Who's that next to him? Someone appears to be dancing with the blue badger.
How do you dance with that?
Look what I'm trying to work out. Did you just robot?
It's just
it?
A very slow robot.
Yeah.
That's literally the dance.
He noticed me. He sure is running over here fast. Oh.
Oh! Wait, Gumshoe is dancing with it? You don't tell me you're a fan. Hey, pal! What are you doing here?
That's my line, Detective Gumshoe. Specifically, why were you dancing over there?
What? Well.
At least he doesn't seem to be busy. This is our chance to get some information.
Yeah, you're not doing your job, so now is your chance to.
Hey, I'll have you know I'm a very busy man, pal.
Oh, no.
Do-do-do-do. What's going on, boyo?
Do we talk to him first?
Let's examine first. This is a brand new scene, right?
We examine the scene first before talking.
Yeah, we always do that.
Okay.
Right?
I don't know. We did the talking first last time before examining his office.
You did that for some certain reason that threw me off a little bit because that's not what you usually do, but you did do it then. But all the times before that, so it's been examined first.
Okay.
So I just thought, I'm going to examine first.
Mr. Wright, do you know why patrol cars are painted black and white?
Because police always bring despair when they drive over.
No idea why. Well, I think they're designed after a panda. Or a teddy bear.
That's one way.
A panda? Not that I have scientific proof, it's just a theory. Do you mind me asking how you came up with that theory?
She's girl map, Pat.
It was when
it
I
all
was
makes
on
sense
a school
now.
Trip. I saw a patrol car and it came to me.
I can't believe the Blue Badger inspired Five Nights at Freddy's.
Oh, me. You know what? He could have.
I mean,
it came out. Right?
Then I not looked into it, but.
We had just been at the zoo, see? Oh, Jesus. What about zebras? Or did that not have those at your zoo? The banner here is announcing the crime fighting campaign. Nice slogan. I wonder if they'll be selling fingerprint sets. Selling fingerprint sets.
Hopefully they're not legit.
I don't think it's that kind of campaign. What family wouldn't want a set at home?
Yeah, just give out guns to citizens. Join us in the fight against crime by causing it.
Yeah. What would the slogan be?
What I just said.
Yeah, I guess so. I think Mo family can figure that out without the extra help. Oh, God.
Also, that guy's interviewing a tunnel snake over there. Or a king. From the kings.
Oh, yeah.
The best faction in Fallout New Vegas.
Look, that patrolman is saluting the other guy. He must be a detective.
And then I said, hey, you do that, you're super get cold, buddy. That's hilarious, sir. I laughed so hard, I cried.
Please give me a raise, sir. Please give me a raise, sir. You have to kiss harder.
What?
Suck up, you know, because going along with the joke.
I didn't think that was going to lead to snogging, but okay.
No, not that kind of suck up. I meant, like, ass kissing.
Oh, right. I thought you meant lip to lip.
No, I meant ass kissing.
Oh, okay. Sorry.
No.
Look, we are playing this game.
That's true. I guess he wasn't saluting. He was wiping tears from his eyes. They make a good pair.
I want a spin-off game of those two.
Could you imagine?
Oh, dear.
Police.
Policia.
I always get excited when I... that's smoke coming out of your... Oh,
no. What? No, nothing's on fire, Ben. No. That's called steam.
I always get excited when I come to the police station. Why is that? Who gets excited when they come to the police station?
Emma does.
It just feels like I'm jumped into a movie.
I feel like she'd love horror films.
Oh, she'd be perfect in them.
She'd be literally taking them apart non-stop and being absolutely enamored by the murders and the way they work and stuff.
Trying to work
some
out
some kind of like nightmare fetishist.
She'd be great in Scream.
Oh, yeah. Oh, geez. I think a lot of people would be great in Scream, to be honest. That franchise is a free-for-all for weirdos and wackos.
Yeah. You know, with all the police and criminals... Well, I don't know if this is all that exciting. Sure it is. Look at those two officers over there. They're probably talking about the latest bust.
Probably not the bust you're thinking of, young lady.
Funny, I thought they were talking about the weather. Okay, what about you?
No. Oh, do we have to?
Yeah. Creepy. I'm wondering about that.
What, the dancing blue badger? It's...
Oh my god, Gumshoe designed it.
You've created a monster.
You've created terrifying. That went on for Five Nights at Freddy's.
You've created a destroyer of worlds, Gumshoe. Yeah.
It's my masterpiece!
No!
Stop making it move. How did you make it move?
You made the piece of crap, Gumshoe?
The chief would have given us some designs and I just did my thing, pal!
Although, how did you actually make it move? That is quite impressive.
Yeah, that's something, I will admit. Yeah. It's just the rest of it is so bad.
Yeah. Nice work!
It's battery powered, so it can go anywhere!
It can come into your house.
Oh, yeah.
There's no switch, so it just dances until the batteries die.
What kind of dog?
It dances eternally.
Yeah. He dropped.
Yeah.
Poor Blue Badger. Fade to dance until he drops.
Fade to boogie on down. That's fucking evidence. Get the hell out of the court record.
Work of art designed by the chief. We gotta examine that shit.
Okay, so it runs on batteries and doesn't stop dancing.
The usual wanted posters are hanging up on the bulletin board here. Oh my god, is that me and you? We're wanted? What? Why?
Wait, what the fuck? Try and make me do edits. Leave me alone.
Okay, that's alright. You know this face? If you do, dial 911. It's easy to insert something in there.
I don't live in America.
Oh.
Or Japanifornia, no. Does that matter?
No, Mr. Right. I always thought it was kind of funny. I've never seen anyone who looked like the people in these posters. You hardly ever even look human. You have a point.
Bad drawings. Very bad drawings. Yeah. Terrible even.
I mean...
Who'd ever want to look at guys like that?
No. Alright. Oh my god.
Oh Jesus, you get the full shot. Okay.
You get to examine it though.
Honestly, I'm not complaining.
I thought we could examine it.
I'd rather not look at its body.
Okay, so I guess we talked to Gumshoe.
Hey, you pal. What's going on with the case? I'll give you one word of advice, pal. You better not agree to defend the suspect in this case. I know you, boy.
Why not?
Oh, I see you. Well, it's just that the chief prosecutor has confessed to the crime. She says she saw the detective at the prosecutor's office and she killed him!
That's who she killed?
Yeah. Oh. Bruce Goodman, remember?
Oh, she killed Bruce Goodman.
Yeah.
Oh. But what if she's not telling the truth?
Yeah, well, no! Come on, pal! There's plenty of evidence against her!
But what if the evidence was fake?
Hey, pal. Let's speak to you for a second.
Huh? Me?
Why is this little girl so peeved at me? Why does this always happen? What is with you and tiny girls?
Tiny does look like a pattern, Phoenix, not gonna lie.
What is with you and adoption?
Yeah.
You loan you or something, pal?
She's a relative of the suspect. She's Lana Sky's sister.
Whoa! The chief prosecutor's little sister!
Just please investigate this case carefully, okay? Scientifically.
Yes, sir! No, oh, by the way! You might want to keep your voices down. Yes, says the
man
in the shower.
It, yeah.
You don't want to be overheard using words like faked.
Huh?
It's a sensitive issue with us these days.
The investigation. So, what are you doing here, Detective Gumshoe?
Me? Oh, well, nothing, really. They kicked me out of criminal affairs.
Oh no!
Oh, you've been demoted?
Detective Gumshoe, what did you do this time? I love that feeling, it's like, what did you do this time?
This time?
Yeah.
What do you mean this time?
Then what happened? I know things are busy right now. I mean, with my sister case and all.
It's true. I've never had a chief prosecutor murder anyone before. Only the highest ranked people are being led into criminal affairs now. The lowest ranking guy in there is our chief of detectives. They're not letting any of us rank and file detectives in law.
None of you? I know this is an important trial, but isn't that a little odd?
So anyway, I thought I'd spend the day getting badger dance down pat.
The badger dance.
Badger dance.
It's now the badger dance. Yeah. Badger, 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 badger,
mushroom,
mushroom,
mushroom, snake on a stake. Oh,
badger, badger.
Isn't there anything else you could be doing?
The chief of police himself is directing this investigation, pal. And Officer Marshall was assigned to the underground parking lot.
Officer Marshall.
Yeah, the cowboy, Mr. Yeehaw.
Now that I think about it, Emma did seem to know that Marshall guy.
Patrolman in charge of a crime scene. It's unheard of, pal.
Right, time to present.
No, this is a patrol dude, and he's not even like So now he's suddenly got a big job to actually fucking look at the scene of the crime. Even though he's just a patrolman, that's weird.
Do you remember my badge?
No. You're an attorney?
Yeah. Detective, here's my attorney badge.
He shows me every time we meet, pal. We'll make sure the police badge! Enough said!
wish I had a badge. Even an ID card would be nice.
Wait. Speaking of ID cards, I found that detective card, didn't I? Oh my god, wait, that
You
actually-
did! We're gonna show that in the next episode, because I'm running out of time.
Oh shit, okay.
Bye everyone! Thank you for watching, everyone, and here's a special shout out to our Dionysus patrons for your wonderful support.
Ace Attorney Fan 621, Annie Melly,
Blackout, Catabag,
Korak, Daniel Taylor,
Dragonzord 720,
Icarus Hinata,
Kyle Biddings,
Leah Baggins,
Naming Master,
Ned Scribbles,
Neon Citizen Teal,
Oku,
Hair Explosion,
Princess Peach, Ray MXH36,
Relucci,
Salon, Sifrax,
Sir Gideon Ofne, the All-Knowing,
Suave 0909, Trilby,
True Divination,
Windy W. Kosaka.
All of our socials can be found in the links down below. Thank you so much once again for supporting us, and have a great day.